Hi, my name is Mathias Schult. I'm a principal software engineer at DNV, and I've been working with the development of Sesam Wind Manager for the last 15 years. Offshore wind turbines are a key player in our renewable energy future. In this video, we are looking into different types of fixed offshore wind substructures and discuss why certain substructures are chosen over others. As a substructure, we define the structure between just above seabed to well above sea level, where the substructure meets the foundation and in the top the wind tower in the transition piece. The main types used for offshore wind substructures are gravity-based, monopiles and jackets, and more seldomly used tripiles and tripods. For the foundations, we see again gravity-based foundations, piled foundations and suction buckets and other hybrid designs. Let's look at the different designs of substructures in more detail. Starting with gravity-based substructures that are massive concrete structures that lay on the ocean seabed and rely on the weight for stability. These are used mainly in shallow waters, and the substructure is used also as a foundation and substructure in combination. With monopiles, we're going into deeper waters. Monopiles are steel tubes driven deep into the seabed, and traditionally they have been used for shallow to medium water depth. But we also see now XXL monopile designs that go into deeper waters. Monopiles are popular due to their simple design and cost effectiveness. Next, we have jacket foundations, which come in the traditional four-leg design, or more commonly seen now also three-legged design. These steel lattice structures provide excellent stability against waves, currents, and also earthquakes. Jackets distribute the loads between multiple points, and that makes them suitable for a variety of seabed conditions, and also greater water depths than monopiles, although there's an overlap between the depth between monopiles and jackets. Tripods and tripiles have also been seen in the past, but are not commonly used anymore. Finally, we're looking into how substructures are fixed to the seabeds through their foundations. There we have suction buckets, we have piles, and again, gravity-based foundations. Pile foundations involve driving piles into the seabed and connect the substructure through grouted connections. Suction buckets are inverted steel or concrete buckets that are sucked through a vacuum to the seabed to provide stability. Each type of substructures has its particularities and challenges that need to be addressed during the conceptual and detailed design phase. Therefore, selecting a tool that fulfills those needs is essential to improve efficiency and minimize costs. Sesam has been on the market for over 50 years and working together with customers to develop solutions to their needs. Sesam offers a comprehensive suite of softwares for designing offshore wind turbine substructures from conceptual design to detailed design. It has proven interfaces to the main aeroelastic tools, such as, for example, bladed. Additionally, it provides flexibility to run your software either on the desktop or in the cloud. If you want to learn more about how Sesam can support your business, please contact us or visit our website.